When you buy a burger, it usually comes with fries and soft drinks. Now, imagine if you buy a burger but it comes with a miso soup or chicken curry. How do you think it would taste? Now, I know some of you may like it, but I do believe that most of us regular folks will probably not. This is my analogy of Helldivers 2 developers saying no to this woke nonsense in their game. These devs do not want to represent the woke idea because it is a game about alien invasions and stopping them. This is a game about shooting fictional aliens trying to invade human settlements, and we the players are trying to stop them. So, going back to the burger analogy, you cannot just add any type of foods in the burger menu because there's a big chance that the regular burger enjoyers are not going to buy that burger, causing a loss of sales. So, a burger will always most likely come with fries and drinks. I personally like that the devs in Helldivers 2 are saying no to these woke requests because these are not needed in the game. It is as simple as that. I have nothing against this woke movement, but it has to be put in the right place and the right time. And video games is not the right place and the right time for this. The request about having a woke flag in-game or having woke representation in-game is really unnecessary and is just causing more work for the developers. Their job is not to cater or fix your feelings or fix the issues we have in society. Their job is to make games, fix the issues in-game, and make content. Also, who's going to pay for these requested things in-game? The regular gamers who doesn't want to be involved with this kind of stuff? The gamers who only wants to play a game, have fun, and escape reality? Also, if they put this woke stuff in-game, is it going to fix the issues in real life? Absolutely not! Now, if the developers are going to add what the woke people want in-game, other people will also request the things that they want. So, if they add woke flags, I'm also going to request Brotherhood of Steel flags, Space Marine flags. How about Terran Marine flags? Do you understand where this is going? It is not a burger anymore. It is something entirely new. That is why a burger will always be good with fries and drinks. If the devs add all these things, then it will be an entirely new game that has lost its identity. The devs don't hate woke stuff. I do not hate woke stuff. Most of the gamers who bought this game doesn't hate woke stuff. But it has to be put in the right place and the right time, and video games is not that place. The woke movement is actually a good cause, but the people handling it are not doing it for the good of the people that they are representing. They are doing it for money and control. They are just latching in video games because if by any chance the video game that they are involved with is successful, they actually get a sprinkle of that success and money. These people are doing it for money and control. The fact that they are willing to cancel any YouTubers that has a different opinion says a lot about themselves. Now, by the end of the day, a video game company is a business. And in the business world, from my own understanding, is that there is a simple fact that stands at the top, and that is profit speaks louder than words. Now, if a company wants to be involved with this woke stuff, there are only two things that can come out from it. One is that it is going to be successful, or it is going to fail, and most likely it is going to fail if they add this woke stuff in it. Video games with woke stuff, if done correctly, is actually good, but most of the time it is done poorly. We have witnessed a lot of games and game companies that are involved with this woke stuff and they are failing horribly. There are game studios that went bankrupt or got shut down because they did not make any profit at all. There are games that was released in the past that are not doing so well and have negative reviews and that actually cost a lot of money. Now, these game companies should have learned not to be involved with this woke stuff because it robs them with their own creativity and artistic design. This woke stuff doesn't need to be represented in video games, it is as simple as that. If game companies are going to represent them, then they better do a very good job or else it will just fail miserably. Believe it or not, Baldur's Gate 3 is actually a game with woke stuff in it, but it was done properly. Now, I know someone will argue that we need woke stuff in video games, but for me, it is not needed. And by the end of the day, we can argue all we want, but the truth is that most gamers only want to play good games and have fun. If you want woke stuff, go ahead and tell the devs that you want that. We are in a free world where we have choices, but you cannot force your wants to others. You cannot just show what you want to others. It's as simple as that. You can cry all you want, but if they say no, then it's a no. If these companies say yes to this woke stuff, then that is their choice, and most likely it is going to fail because the burger doesn't need anything else. All it needs is the fries and the drinks. If these companies try to change the menu, then good luck to you. The worst part of this is when a gaming company goes bankrupt or gets shut down because of woke content and poor sales. These activists are going to blame the consumers for not wanting their products. They will immediately blame the consumers for not being able to understand their motives and values. They also don't get punished. They just move on as if nothing happened. We live in a free world where everything is possible. Gaming companies have a choice: make a fun game or make a game with woke content. My say to this is good luck and hope to God, or hope to whatever you believe in, that the finished product that you are going to make is really good. Because if not, it will not sell well. It is as simple as that. One of the easiest way to tell if a product or game is successful is through the market. The market will dictate what the consumers want, and that is how we know if a game is successful or not. You can search a game and check if a game is good or not by simply looking at the sales or check the Steam charts. The market does not care about your ideology or values. It's all about supply and demand, and gamers want is a fun game. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Good job to the Helldivers 2 developers.